The cargo ship Ezadeen lies empty at Corigliano Calabro in southern Italy, after being abandoned by smugglers and left on the Ionian Sea for days. The ship departed from somewhere in Turkey and sailed the sea for more than 10 days before being towed in by port authorities. The ship was carrying more than 350 migrants and refugees. Upon arrival, all were given food and shelter in makeshift tents on the harbour. Most here are women, children and men from Syria fleeing the war. Their risky journey has finally brought them to Europe, to safety. Mohammed is one of this young group of students who risked his life trying to escape.
I was studying in dental school in Aleppo, so I was in the last year. But I went out because of the awful situation in Syria.
Some are university colleagues who decided to make this journey together.
10 days ago, they told us there is a journey, so we went to some place. They put us in cars, closed cars. After that, they took us, I don't know where. We climbed, across the rocks. After that, we get a small ship. They took us to this ship. After 5 days, the food and the water finished up from the ship.
Slowly, the migrants and refugees go through the identification procedures. Then they will be sent to different reception centres around Italy. Mohammed, however, plans to go even further.
I plan to go to Germany to continue my study.
Since the end of Mare Nostrum, recent cargo ships like the Ezadeen signal a new trend in human smuggling on the Mediterranean Sea.